I fucks with contracts. That's why niggas got a problem with me. If you sign the motherfucking contract, that's what the fuck it is. But they're so used to niggas fucking around with the contract and being nervous because they might lose an opportunity or a motherfucking chance, so they will redo the contract. I'm not a bitch who will redo the contract. If you sign the motherfucker, that's what the motherfucker is. So do not. See, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to break it down for you, Detroit, because I would feel less than a motherfucking woman if I didn't let y'all know what the fuck was going on this stage right now. So if my energy is a little different, niggas, because they got me fucked up. So the contract, oh nigga, the motherfucking contract said that a bitch is the headliner. The headliner. Let me say it again, the headliner. That's what the motherfucking contract says. Monique is to be the last motherfucking person on the goddamn stage. She is the headliner. That's what I signed the fuck up for. I'm 30 plus years in this motherfucking business and I don't open for no goddamn body. The contract said the headliner. The contract said the headliner. The contract said the headliner. But a nigga named Bill Hughley turned into a bitch and said I won't perform if she does that. I won't go out if she does that. Nigga, you open for the kings of comedy. I close for the queens of comedy, nigga.
Yeah, so we just played Monique's stand-up portion of her show where she was going off on DL Hughley. So then next from there, DL posted this on his Instagram. It basically said, all you have to do is check the order of the names on the ticket stuff from last night and you'll see who's confused. He says, against his better judgment, over the objections of his team and four other occasions where I said no, I decided to take a chance and work with Monique. Oprah was the problem. Tyler Perry was the problem. Charlamagne was the problem. Steve Harvey was the problem. Lee Daniels was the problem. Netflix was the problem. Now it's my turn. At some point, it can't be everyone else. It's you. Lesson learned. I didn't have anything personal against Monique. People paid a lot of money to laugh, not to hear about your contract. Apparently, the role you played in Precious turned out to be an autobiography. I wonder who's next. So that was a mouthful, and I had seen this and I was thinking, okay, maybe he's right. Maybe Monique is the issue. And then he said, after this, I don't want to hear no more about this. Here it is in black and white. The only thing blacked out is personal and bank information. Pay attention to headliner, highest paid artist on show, artist to have approval of lineup of the show, which was DL for the closing. He said, receipts are better than opinions. I got everything that was stated in my contract, everything. But let's say I didn't. My beef wouldn't be with anyone but the promoter and my team, and I damn sure wouldn't make it personal. If you have a problem, take it up with management, and by that I mean yours. Daryl Lynn Hughley. So at this point, you know, I'm looking at the comments and seeing what everybody's saying, because at this point it's almost like a tennis ball going back and forth. He posts his stuff and everybody's like, oh, okay, he came through with receipts. I even seen Tank and some other celebrities in the comments like, that's why you always got to have receipts. So at this point, you know, the ball swung to DL and everyone was like, okay, Monique is back at it again. So then, and this is actually a copy of what he had posted, and it says Dale memo. So, and then he had a copy of the lineup. It does show him at the end.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Right.
So, can I comment on that?
Yes.
So, I looked at both of the contracts. I looked at Monique's, and I also looked at DL's. And when I looked at DL's, his really wasn't from my point of view and from what I've seen, it doesn't look like an agreement. it just looks like an artist, you know, demands. So basically, when you look at DL, what DL was showing up there, it seemed like that's what his team wrote down to send to the promoter or whoever was booking them to be able to book them for the show.
Right.
Because it even has DL's tax ID number. You don't put that on the agreement. You understand?
How do you know that they wouldn't? Because that maybe it's needed to be there to for payment. No,
they wouldn't put that on the agreement. You know what I mean? As far as I would think, because the agreement would just be what it, you know, would be, you know, the whole sign thing and what's going on, who they're picking. It'll say, just like Monique, it will say Monique described as the talent from here forward. Monique talent will be representing Monique in this, you know, agreement.
Mm-hmm.
DL Hughley's the thing that he posted was doesn't say all that. It just says, you know, 100% headliner. Like I said, it's like a list of demands,
right?
Which is
you
fine.
You would send over. This is what we want. Yeah. If I get this, I'll sign a contract.
Yeah, that's what it looks like to me.
Right.
So,
because it does say memo, it doesn't say contract. And I will tell you that Monique, like you said, you saw it as well as I did. She produced the actual contract.
Yeah, she showed an art a performance agreement.
Right.
You know. So DL Hughley didn't post a performance agreement that said anything about who's being a headline or not. It just shows that his demands, basically the whole thing kind of shows his demands within that contract, and whatever he got blacked out probably was the demand of how much he's supposed to get paid and this and that and that.
Right.
Whether he got that or not, we don't know. But you know, that's not what the argument is.
And before you say that, I just want to say that we're, you know, I put up the pictures of Monique's actual contract just to make it fair, you know, because I have DL's memo up there. So, but go ahead.
Yeah. So, now in DL's defense, although he probably, like I said, that's not a performance agreement. Let's just say maybe, and I think I mentioned that to you earlier, maybe the promoter booked them both as a headliner, you know.
That's kind of,
you know, maybe that was the case. You know, whoever signed the contract first probably was supposed to be will be able to get the headliner slot. Who knows? But
well, I kind of feel like she might have been the headliner. And even what she said when we listened to the clip is that he went up there or whatever he did ahead of time and said, I'm not performing unless I'm the headliner. And I think he, you know, the people probably were backed into a corner and let him have his way.
Yeah.
And the reason why I also think that is because how he came to her in his Instagram post is taking, you know, low blows, like talking about Precious was her autobiography. If you're standing on business, like she just came through with the contracts and was like, this is what I signed. What did you sign? But if you have to resort to pettiness, to me, that means that you were guilty of something. And then he had to try to manipulate us into thinking she's the problem, which is why he named all those people Tyler Perry, Oprah. But at the end of the day, a few of those people did admit that they did her wrong.
Yeah,
you know?
So let's just say this real quick. I only say in DL Hughley's defense, as far as the promoter, I was just coming up with, well, maybe. But let's take a step back, right? Monique said in her rant that DL Hughley said, no, if that's the way it is, I'm not doing the show.
The contract said the headliner, but a nigga named DL Hughley turned into a bitch and said, I won't perform if she does that.
So that almost kind of tell me that when he found out that Monique was the headliner, right, that would have been the reason why he said that he's not performing.
That's exactly what I think happened.
So he got there.
Yep.
And found out that he's not the headliner,
right,
which means that Monique had to have been right.
Right.
According to a contract, because Why would he say what he said?
Right.
If anything, it would be the opposite thing. It would be Monique probably saying something like that, you know.
Right.
And I think if Monique knew that she wasn't going to be the headliner, she wouldn't have showed up anyway.
Right. I get that feeling too, because she feels as though she was entitled to that. Like she said, you know, he opened up for the Kings of Comedy and she closed for the Queen of Comedy. So that was saying a statement right there.
So I think, you know, although Monique is loud, and I think people are just not used to that, and the word that they want to use is difficult, but she's not difficult. She just speak up.
That's what I don't even mean to interrupt you, but I totally agree, because I'm the same way. And when you stand up for yourself, you know, people try to make you out to be the villain. But she had her business documents, and it wasn't no memos, it was contracts. So say what you want about her, but she'll back it up with facts, not opinions.
Yeah, she be checking everybody too. But anyway,
but she be right though.
You know, it's just sad. Like, you know, for me, I see a black queen fighting for a lot of queens.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then you see queens, other black queens, stopping her from fighting for them.
Right.
You know what I mean? I watched this interview, and I'll try to plug it in if I can remember.
Yeah.
It's a radio interview with I think the girl's name, host was, her name was Sanana. She's a radio host. S-A-N-A or something like that. And the other guy, I think his name was Tony or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, the radio station was somewhere out in on the West Coast. I think it was like 106K something. But anyway, so they did this interview, and this was like 2018, and the girl was just like mad. She had like an attitude with Monique the whole thing. And then, so, you know, she just got onto the interview, and she's just talking to the guys and just kind of just, you know, just chatting it up.
Mm-hmm.
And then she was just like, all right, well, let's get into this. Da-da-da. She just like cut her off. She's like, let's get into this and let's talk about the whole thing. And then Monique just cut her off and said, we're going to get there. And then finish talking to the guys about whatever they were talking about. I think they were talking about a game or something.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, it was like the girl was just like ready to attack her. And you know what I mean? Instead of just kind of welcoming her as a guest.
Right, right.
She was just like already had, you know,
hostility towards her.
You know? Mm-hmm. So I just think people are... You know, some people feel
it's like you said earlier, they think she's difficult because she's believing in what she believes in, you know what I mean, as far as standing up for herself, you know, and she's not gonna take half-ass stuff, you know. She's to a T with contracts and what she's worth, and it's all about knowing your worth. And, you know, it's like sometimes they try to break you down because black women already get that stereotype that we're hostile and we're this and we're that, you know. But it's sad when you see women also doing the same thing. But that's the card that I feel like DL pulled on her. You know, there's a long list of people that you have problems with. But when people come out, even Lee Daniels recently apologized.
Yeah.
She's not always in the wrong. There may be times that she may be in the wrong, but so far it seems like she knows. She's very smart about the business. I know her husband's her manager, and he's probably leading her, you know, the right way on how to deal with things and how to get what you're worth, which what husband wouldn't. But it's made her like, be, you know, a difficult person in the industry because of it.
Made her look that way.
Right. It made her look that way.
Yeah, just because, you know, she's speaking up. So anyway, you know, everyone's going to be entitled to their opinion. You know, can Monique be a different way? You know, she's from the hood for the most part. You know what I mean? So she's just going to be her. But yes, there's other ways to handle it. You can still be aggressive and speak up for yourself and maybe do it in a more, you know, you can do it in different ways. you know, speaking
well,
up and speaking up.
She's not beating nobody yeah. up. She's yeah, not shooting you know. Up, you know, or and I think, running on stage beating up comedians and stuff. So
yeah, yeah. I just think people just not, people don't want to see a black woman being that aggressive. They just want them to be silently aggressive. And if they don't get their way, they need to silently walk away or something like that. And Monique's just not that person.
Nope.
You know? But yeah, man. You know, that's what I think. That agreement, I believe Monique's side of the story. I don't believe DL Hughley. And you know, that's Hollywood for you. That's how it is. You know, he's gonna, if he's down with Tyler Perry and everybody else, you know, mm-hmm. you know, maybe he's looking to get some type of deal, so he wants to be on their side of the ballpark.
Right.
You know.
Yep, I totally agree.